Okay, I hope you're in the holiday spirit because I have a super fun warm-up video for you. It is the 12 days of fitness. So there are going to be 12 different exercises that you're going to do to the 12 day of Christmas song. The video is only 3 minutes long. So try to do it every day this week as like a little brain break, maybe in between math or science or reading or writing or whatever lessons you're doing with your e-learning classes to get your heart pumping. Now, the video goes twice in 3 minutes. So the first time is at a slower pace, and then the second time is super silly because it goes fast, but it's a lot of fun. So I hope you enjoy it. Okay, and now on to our lesson of the week. Our lesson has to do with soccer. Now, obviously, we don't all have a soccer ball, and that's okay, but you have to learn the skill cues that go along with soccer. So the first thing I put up here is first watch some legendary soccer goal video. It's really cool to see how amazing these athletes are and how well they can control the ball and the power they have when they shoot it into the goal. We're going to talk about some soccer skill cues together, and then you're going to answer some soccer test questions. But if you do have a soccer ball, go outside, explore some of these soccer skills. And if you don't have a soccer ball, but you have like a bouncy ball, a beach ball, you could still try some of these activities and have fun passing with a brother, sister, cousin, whoever, mom, dad, shooting. You don't have to have a goal to shoot. You can use two trees in your yard as a boundary line or whatever you want to use to have fun with soccer skills. Okay, so the main things of soccer are dribbling. When you dribble, you tap the ball gently so it stays near your feet at all times. I always tell the kids tap, tap, tap and keep it nice and close. Number two, use the inside of your foot when you dribble. So Big Coach, can you scan down at me and I'm going to show what some dribbling looks like. So I just tap, tap, tap. I keep the ball nice and close. And my eyes, you want to try to look up as much as you can when you're dribbling the ball. You can look down sometimes, but you don't want to stare down the entire time because then you're not going to have good control in where you're going. Number three, look for open spaces as you travel. That's really important because of defense. If you're going right to somebody, you're going to get caught by the defense. And number four, trap or stop the ball by putting your foot on top of the ball to stop it, just like they are in that picture. So half of soccer is dribbling, and then the other half of soccer has to do with passing, trapping, kicking. Now, when you kick the ball, whether you're passing it or shooting it, you always use either your shoelaces or the inside of your foot. Never your toe. That's bad, okay? You don't have much control over where it's going to go if you make contact with your toe. You want to use, like I said, the inside of your foot, and the inside has a special name. It's called instep. So it can be referred to as two different words, inside of your foot or instep. And your laces. So what happens is you point your toe down, and you can make contact with your laces when you go to kick the ball. When you kick, you also have to lock your ankle and keep it nice and tight so you can control the ball. If it's floppy, you're not going to be able to control where you want it to go. And then two other dots. We're not going to worry about this stuff. It's blurry, and that's okay because that's some more detailed stuff, but we're not concerned with that as much. We want to get with some of the basics right now for soccer. It says contact the ball directly behind the center for travel at low level. So for example, soccer can kind of be a little bit like science. The ball, if you kick the ball in the center, it's going to stay on the ground. Okay? But if you kick it here, it's going to go up into the air. So if you do have access to a goal or something that you want to shoot at and you want to try to make the ball go in the air, you just kind of hit the bottom of it, and that can help send it up into the air to get what you see in that video of the legendary soccer goals. That's how they make it go up into the air. And then the last thing, focus on the ball as you kick and receive. That's really important. Eye contact. If you're not looking at your partner, you're not ready to receive the ball. okay? So as the ball's coming to you, you've got the eye contact, and your body has to be ready in order to receive the ball. And you can trap it using the inside of your foot when someone's passing it to you, okay? I know it shows trapping like this. That's more when you're dribbling it, because when it's coming to you, if you do that, sometimes you miss the ball and it rolls right by you. So these are some things you can explore with. Have fun. The one other thing I did not talk about yet, Big Coach, if you can zoom in on this picture, is your actual foot placement when you go to pass a ball. One foot goes next to the ball, and one foot goes behind the ball. So it's kind of making like an L shape if you're right-footed. If you're left-footed, it's going to make the opposite backwards L shape. So Big Coach, if you can look down at me, my dominant foot is my right foot. So I put my right foot behind the ball, my left foot to the side, and I have my L position. And when I want to pass it, I lock that ankle and I follow through. So have fun with the soccer skills. But if you don't have a ball, like I said, you're going to answer. Everyone has to answer the soccer questions, but I hope you have time to explore with it. The weather's been beautiful, and be fun to go outside. So, thanks, guys.
Left-hand side of your screen. So when you go in Canvas, there's going to be a thing that says quizzes. So find that quizzes part, click on that, and that's where you're going to find your soccer quiz and other quizzes that we've given too. So if you're behind on anything, get caught up. We only have a few more weeks left. We miss you guys. Can't wait to see you again.
Bye.
Bye.